Hello everyone, my name is Iana Komarnytska and today I'm joined by Pedro Bonatto and this is Tips from the Iana Dance Club. And in this video I'm gonna talk about so-called square, which we are talking about in ballet dance world, about drum solo improvisation, the fact that drummers who are experienced and know how to play for dancers typically will repeat their phrases of drumming phrases 4 times. Sometimes 8, but typically it's a square of 4. So if he's playing the same music in his or concept in his music, as a dancer, we also will kind of play the same concept in our bodies, our movements. And you don't really have to switch in one square of like this repetition of 4 into many different movements. You don't need to go arabesque, jump, turn, shimmy, everything together. You actually can choose literally to do one combo and to do it 4 times. But repeat combos just 4 times, it's very boring and not interesting. So what are the variations that we can do? There are several things. First, you can play with the directions. You can do first time the combo towards the audience, second towards one diagonal, towards another diagonal, then back towards audience. Second option, you can take it literally in different direction. One towards audience, next time towards the wall, next time facing back to the another side. This is literally, I did a square on the floor and that's how it comes from in ballet dance world. We can talk about concept of square. But also you can play around with switching off body parts. So for instance, the first 2 parts of the square, you can do some combo from the chest area, let's say switching diagonals. Now, you don't want to repeat exactly, you can do the same style of combo. For instance, if I was doing accents and shimmy, I can do accents with hips and shimmy and keep switching diagonal. So variations of directions and body parts already give you a lot of variety in your dancing, and at the same time you can represent music very nicely, because it would be strange if a musician plays the same idea in his phrase but you as a dancer suddenly switch to completely different ideas in your dancing. So let's see how it works on practice, and I'll ask Pedro to play a couple of phrases as he would play it in drum solo options. Demo. That was pretty obvious. So I was doing very simple basic dance combos, but different directions already brought very much variety and richness into dance. And also we did a little synchronic ending. So you can play around with this concept and idea, and of course ideally find a drummer to practice together and find the synchronicity and to be able to reach it, to kind of read each other's mind. But if you want to discover about more tools about drum solo improvisation, including more in depth about the square or how to finish synchronically together with a drummer, or how to play and what kind of movements you can do as interaction with drummer, or many, many more tools like that to be ready for drum solo improvisation. In this case, I recommend to check out Iana Dance Club, which we are doing the whole intensive about drum solo improvisation, and also we are doing it in a magical place in Cappadocia, and specifically this tip. And we have the whole drill also recorded in this beautiful room, which is 300 years old room in a famous Henna hotel in Cappadocia, in Gureme. Shout out to them, beautiful place. And if you want to improve your drum solo improvisation skills and also discover magical landscapes and views of Cappadocia, check out Iana Dance Club. You can find it at ianadanceclub.com. Link will be in the description to the video. And of course, if you want more tips like this, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you next time.